Hi friends, coming at you from the confines of my home in the Bay Area, and I am now coming out of week 5 and going into week 6 of shelter in place, aka COVID-19 quarantine. But I'm not gonna lie, week 5, it's getting tough, and you know, the days and the weekends are all kind of the same thing. I'm still busy at work, and every family and everyone's being impacted in different ways. That all being said, you're just trying to be productive and make the most of what you have. Part of that, I was able to have some time to look back through old footage. And for those who know me really well, like, I've always taken a lot of videos and clipped a lot of videos together, but I've always kept it pretty, like, just among my friends and my family. But there are a couple that I've come across and I just really want to share. And the first one is one of my first trip to Havasupai Indian Reservation. We did a backpacking and a camping trip there, some friends and I. And I've had the pleasure to go there twice, and both within a year. So there's a story there too. And I just ended up going to both. And for me, they were both very different experiences. So the video you're gonna see is about the first trip I took there in early November of 2018. So the main difference between the two trips had to do with the weather and the time of the year that we went. So the first time I went, it was late fall transitioning into winter. So it was cold. It was much colder than the second time I went. And also we had a lot less daylight. And there are some things that happened along the way, like had someone get hurt and on the hike in. So that did slow us down a little bit. But if you go to my Instagram channel, and at my profile on the top, there's like a highlight, the highlight stories. If you see, I have one of Havasu. That is a highlight reel of my second trip there. You'll notice it's much more vibrant, like the land and the water. And I think it was because it was right after the rainy season. We went in May for the second time, and it was much warmer. We had more daylight, like extended during the day. Like any time of the year you go, it will be amazing. And so I just wanted to share a little bit of that with you all. I was looking through it. And I'm like, oh, this is too good not to share. So I hope you enjoy the video or the vlog. And for those of you who are interested in perhaps doing the trip, you like backpacking, you like camping, go to the link in my description box below, and you'll find the information there. But just a heads up, I think the permits become available in February. So you have to get permits to get into the park, or into the reservation, I should say. And just letting you know, these permits sell out real quick. It's like the draft. Or like, it took us about an hour for a couple of us to get to an actual purchase screen. So keep trying. Have multiple people manning and kind of going at it. And I think that's it. Okay, so just kidding. I wanted to actually quickly include a brief overview of how we got from point A to point B, just in case it'd be helpful.
So in terms of logistics, most of us are based in San Francisco. And so we took a flight from San Francisco International, and we took a direct flight into Vegas. And when we landed in Vegas, we got our rental cars. We used Turo. It was super convenient. We basically just picked those cars up from the parking lot, and then headed to a town called Henderson. It's not too far, and we rented an Airbnb, and this is where we were able to really transition into backpack mode, fix our packs, and just prep for, you know, the hike through the reservation and through the desert to Havasu, or the falls, I should say, and campsite. So after that, we woke up really early the next morning and went from Henderson to the Indian reservation. I think the drive was about 4 hours long, give or take. And so, we wanted to get an early start so we can maximize our 2 nights and 3 days in the reservation. You can stay up until 3 nights and 4 days, but for our group, we decided that we're gonna go with 2 nights and 3 days. It was just a group decision that we made. And so, we enjoyed our time. And then when we got out of the reservation, we went straight back to Vegas. We drove from Havasu to Vegas directly and spent a night here. We took some nice hot showers and had some good food. We did a buffet there and just enjoyed some downtime and the off work time that we had together. Then obviously after Vegas, we then took a flight back to home base, San Francisco. So hopefully that helps.
And I think that's really it. So yeah, if there are any other questions or thoughts that come top of mind that I didn't cover, please feel free to drop a comment or DM me, and I'll definitely try and just share what I know. Yeah.
And with that, I'm gonna cut out and leave you all to just enjoy the fun and the sights, because I've probably talked way too much now. So I will catch you in my next one soon-ish, I think. Bye. And go.
A little bit of misfit banter, a little bit of JoJo dancer, a little bit of thoughts of mine coming out the mind of this midnight rambler. I can't wait till these tunes of mine get me out of this local jam. Get up on that big stage now, show the world just who the heck I am. Ever think that if it all goes right, you got something that could change your life? Use that moment just to show your light. Everything is gonna be alright, 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 alright. Crashing through the sky. Just might find it. And there's some around who wanna keep you down, but shawty, don't be blinded. Hey. Feeling trapped, thinking that you can't get out of this humdrum scene. Time to turn this thing upside down. Show these people what you really mean. Ever think that you could lose your mind? Could it be the big dream you'll find? No more waiting, cause it's almost time. Everything is gonna be alright, 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 alright. Crashing through the sky.
Awesome.
La 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 la.